Hey everybody, how you guys doing? Good, we're starting up another 420 Bible study and Torah tour. I'm Charlie, I will be your teacher. I am the Messiah, I am the anointed one. I know the oil of joy, I'm a Kohen, I make everything go up in smoke. I'm the seed of David, I'm the second offering, I'm the descendant of Aaron, I'm a Levitical priest. How's that for a resume? Okay, that's a resume. So in today's Leviticus 2, we're just going to finish it with some of the other offerings that we were talking about. So the name of God, and we'll start with actually, we'll go back to the Quran because I have my hand on it. We'll just open it up and it says, let's see, the covenant is broken. The covenant, chapter 5, verse 13, the covenant is broken. And we talked about the covenant. God says in Malachi, the warning at the end, hey, keep the covenant I gave to Moses. And Jesus says, not one word's going to drop from the law. And yet Hashem's name is gone. And we have an idol in the form of a man, in the image of something that God did not say to do. And Jesus has a God and Jesus has a Father. So we're really confused, and I'm here to teach the correctness. So we're just going to read the covenant is broken in 5:13 of the Quran, and then we're going to get to the Torah and read about the covenant. Actually, we're going to go to 1 Corinthians 10 too. See, when you have the brain turned on and God says, well, what about 1 Corinthians 10? There's the covenant. I'm like, oh, you're right. So we're going to open up to 1 Corinthians 10, and if I can get... I wasn't planning on doing 1 Corinthians 10, so I actually didn't. Friends, Romans, 1 Corinthians 10. Great. Where is it? 1 Corinthians 10. We're just going to prepare all the stuff. Here it is. Ooh, that title is Warning from Israel's History. It's a Jewish family tree. It's not Christianity. That's insanity. There's no three-in-one concept. It's not Catholicism, it equals alcoholism. There's no Hashem in that. And you have no belief system. Though you make an attempt to burn incense, you make an attempt to wash the cup and put on beautiful robes and garments and have everybody bow down at your feet, that's not what it is. That's not what this book teaches. This book is about food and healing from a tree based on a scientific system called the endocannabinoid system. Nobody can argue science because that's what we turn to. That's why God created it. But if you disobey God, you're going to get the plagues, which is what we have today, including a new strain of COVID, which a coworker of mine just spent the last 2 weeks out because she was sick. And I'm like, really? You brought COVID next to me? He's like, don't worry. I don't have to worry about COVID. And if I get COVID, I'm going to kick God's ass, okay? I'm going to kick my dad's ass because I shouldn't get sick. I trust him that much. And this is where you start just thinking differently. Thinking and thanking the King. Welcome to the kingdom. So the covenant is broken. But for breaking their covenant, we condemned them and hardened their hearts. Oh my goodness. God hardened Pharaoh's heart in Leviticus 3,500 years ago. Everybody who's not with Moses and Aaron has a hard heart. That is the world. That is the strange part about it. I'm like, I'm the only one who's been hard charred? Welcome to Hanukkah and CH for hard or char. You have to melt down the heart. You have to break it down slowly. Okay. You can't just take a house down that you built up for 50 years and say, oh, I'm just going to start again. No, you have to tear it down, take it all away, have new plans. And that's just called reading and breathing every day and underlining and listening. And then going out and telling everybody, hey, there's a system called cannabis. That's the endocannabinoid system. That is the covenant of food for eternal life. And then no one's going to believe you. Oh, that's exactly what's happening. And when I start to get more than 2 likes, okay, or maybe 10 likes and maybe 100 views of a video, that would be nice. Okay, that would be the start of a domino effect. I have one student Hey, Laura. And I'm very happy to have her at that point. Great. And I'm waiting for another student of mine who was an old student to show up. Her name's Denise. If she actually watches this video, that would be the strangest thing, but I should give her a little credit. So this is for breaking the covenant. We condemned them and we hardened their heart. They distorted the words of the scripture. Okay, the Greek is the gospel. The Torah is the scripture. It's the script. God wrote a play. The Greeks wrote a play. Everybody writes a play. Okay, this is about a fireplace. And you are the main character in this cartoon because you get in your car and you drive off, but you also have a cardiovascular system. It's the heart. The heart in the car for a crash cart when you have heart failure. There's no more failing this class anymore. I'm going to make sure all of my students pass the bong, pass the class. And the sentence is, can I pass you? Yes, can I pass? So it says, breaking the covenant because they distorted the words of the scripture and neglected a portion of what they had been commanded to uphold. Numbers 28. They neglected Numbers 28. They neglected the food. And it says it in the Quran because this is the cure. This is the end. I mean, once you have, I also have the Kibbutz Nagast, this one. And this one is the glory of kings. So if you know what the glory is from the fire and the wood in Exodus 40 and the cloud that speaks from heaven in Exodus 19:9, and the smoke of the incense and revelations, and you know the Ark of the Covenant, and you know the law. Guess what? That proves I'm a king. I've been anointed. I've read the book more than three times. I've written it more than three times. I know the law. People would say you don't. I'm like, well, let's open up the law and see if you keep it. Because Jesus says confidently, Moses gave you the law, and yet not one of you keep it. And he also says, Moses is your accuser. Your conscience is actually your accuser. It's called a guilt conscience. It's why the Jews jokingly say, oh, we always feel guilty. You should. You abandoned the Torah. You went off in different directions. There's still some Hasidic Jews, Ashkenazi Jews. At that point, I wish it was just Judaism. The daily offerings of Hashem. So they distort the words of the scripture, neglect a portion of what has been commanded to uphold. You, O prophet, will always find deceit on their part. D.C. Washington, D.C. versus the CDC. Except for a few. But pardon them and bear with them. Indeed, God loves the good doers, the righteous. He does not like everybody. He does not love everybody. If someone tells you God loves everybody, they're lying to you. Because it says in the Ten Commandments, if you hate me, I'm going to hate you. Unless you love me and keep my commandments, then I will show my love to you as a fragrant offering of Ephesians 5. And Malachi 1 says, Israel doubted God's love. I think Adam doubted God. Eve doubted God. The serpent is just the voice in our head that we came up with for Satan instead of understanding that God created plants, animals, and mankind. And women came of man. Okay, that's it. Now we have the spirit kind, which is much more kind and gentle. It's a voice. Nothing physical. There's no God to tug or hug. Tug, I said. But if I could hold myself and I could love my neighbor as myself, in thought, it would be for him. So, going back to what it says, breaking the covenant, it says the word pardon. Pardon me, excuse me, forgive me for going through you. Pardon me, pardon me, pardon me. But in French, it's par Don, par, parlay. In heaven, it's charlay. It's lay. I laid out, I caught it, I sacrificed my body. I laid off that pitch. I got laid off. I got paid off. So the par and the don is the char and the doff. You're going to have to offer the incense for God to forgive you, which means you're going to have to understand what you're reading, which means you're going to have to burn the bush like Moses. And trust me, Moses killed somebody. He killed. He was a murderer and murderers off in jail somewhere before they had jails. But he was like, oh, I killed somebody. And now I'm sure that's all was in his brain. But then one day when he was 80 years old, an old man was Moses at 80 years old before he met Hashem. He had gone to Egypt. He was born Jewish, came out of the water, right? The whole story. But when he's 80, he has the burning bush experience. And he hears a voice. And God says, hey, take off your sandals. You're standing on holy ground, Moses. Doff me. Honor me. Fear me. Hear me. Respect me. And Moses heard God from the fire and the cloud. And Eminem says, the voice in our head. So, what does it say about the covenant? Don't screw it up. Keep the covenant. Now, let's go to 1 Corinthians 10 and listen to warning, warning, warning. Oh, crap. Let's go to Revelations. Revelations 22 for the first warning. Revelations 22 for the warning. Here it is. Warning, warning, warning. I warn everyone. Jesus is sending a flare. Warning sign. Hello. Everyone who hears the words of this prophecy of the scroll, if anyone adds anything to them, God will add to that person the plagues described in this scroll. You added Jesus. You get sickness. Jesus is not going to heal you because you actually need to breathe Jesus because he is the bread on fire as an aroma of Christ. We don't know what the book says. So don't add a word. Don't change Hashem's name. And don't add or take away. Because it says, and if anyone takes a word away from this scroll of prophecy, God will take away from that person any share in the tree of life that is described in this scroll. So in Revelations, don't add a word. Don't worship another God. He is not God in human form. God is actually dwelling in all of us because he is actually his own individual concept. He can talk to you. He can smell. He can say things. He can feel, though he's invisible. Okay? Then, and if you take away God's name, well, at that point, you have no share in the tree of life or hash or hemp seed or Jewishness because you speak foolishness. Now, here's 1 Corinthians 10, the warnings from Israel's history. It's Israel's history. It's the history of Israel. It's right here in 1 Corinthians 10. Let's read it. For I do not want you to be ignorant of the fact, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, that our brothers and sisters, our Jewish ancestors, were all under the cloud. That's God. God is a cloud. You can breathe him. It's love. You can talk about him. He'll be high. You'll be high. You can say hi. They were all baptized into Moses. What? Baptized into Moses? Baptized into the cloud? Didn't John the Baptist come baptizing a baptism of repentance? Yes. And that is where the cloud appeared to Jesus at his baptism in the fire and the cloud. And the cloud spoke from heaven, saying, "This is my son. With him I am well pleased." Now you will hear that. And when you start pleasing God by following what he instructed us to do every day, sit with him, read him a story, go off to work, come back home, read him another story, give him some food, and kiss your father goodnight, you'll know he's pleased with you. Because you'll just know it. How will I know? How will I know? You'll know. Trust me, you will know. So, they were under the cloud. They passed through the sea. They were baptized into Moses in the cloud and in the Red Sea. They all ate. Here's the food again. The food. It's not imaginary food. It's real food. Jesus says, you're going to have to eat my flesh and drink my blood. It's real food. God is real. Hence the word Israel. Is reality. God is reality. It's in real time. So they all ate and drank the same spiritual food and drank the same spiritual drink. And for they drank from the spiritual rock that accompanied them, and that rock was Christ. Okay, is Christ a rock or a human? Well, he's human. So it was the rock was the food, which is the foundation of the book, which is wood, firewood. Nevertheless, God was not pleased with most of them, and their bodies were scattered in the wilderness, dead. But before we're dead, God scatters our thoughts. Yeah, scatterbrain. I don't know what I'm doing. Yeah, it's a crazy day. Ah, how was your day? It's crazy. Long day. Glad it's over. That's not what I say. I'm like, can't wait to wake up in the morning and do it again. And do it again and do it again and repeat and repeat and repeat. And you get really good at the day. New Year's Day and Groundhog Day. And we just enjoy the day. So now these things occurred as examples to keep us from setting our hearts on evil things. Okay, the world is not evil. It's just not God. It's unclean. It's unpure. There's no filter. There's no second thought. There's no belief in God as what it says. There's no tree of life. We're not talking about that. We're all saying Jesus Christ is coming back with the cloud. Okay, I'm here. The anointed one, the Christ, the Messiah, the messenger. Okay, hello. It pinch me. I seem to have found more information than most people. And it says right here in the Ten Commandments, which I keep in my room. You should see my wall. It's just filled with thoughts. But it says, you shall have no other gods before me. Therefore, Jesus Christ says, pray to your Father. They're separate. The cloud speaks from heaven. Jesus says, my Father, listen to me. I'm going to pray to my Father. You're going to pray to your Father. David prayed to his God. Moses prayed to, actually Moses just spoke to God. I just talked to the guy. I'm like, we're like best friends hanging out all day, every day. You shall not make for yourself any idol. So far we haven't gotten anything correct on this test. You shall not take the name of your Lord God in vain. We're 0 for 3. Remember the Sabbath day. Pretty much not. We don't remember squat. Honor or doff your father and your mother. You do not honor. You do not obey. We are guilty, guilty, guilty. And then we steal. That's a different concept. So this is the warnings from Israel's history. So there's the Lord's Supper. Jesus had the Last Supper. And speaking of the food, let's just get to the end of Leviticus 2. It says the oven-baked offerings, so you wake and bake, totally okay. The pan-baked offerings, the deep pan offerings, and the covenant of salt, which is what Jesus said. And I don't mean to assault you, but that's a little humor in the restaurant industry because we have salt and I could assault you. Sorry, it's a little restaurant humor. So, when you offer a meal offering that is baked in an oven, It shall be of fine flour, unleavened loaves mixed with oil, or unleavened wafers smeared with oil. Now, I want to introduce a concept that's going to blow your mind. But you know how the Jewish people have matzah? Okay, well, that matzah has to go up in smoke now, guys. That matzah has to be on fire. That is unleavened bread. Can you imagine having matzah and having it be cannabis? Oh, that is so cool. Oh, my goodness. So, this is the pan-baked offering. This is all daily, by the way. If your offering is a meal offering or a meat offering on the pan, it shall be of fine flour mixed with oil. It shall be unleavened. You shall break it into pieces and pour it upon it. It is a meal offering. If your offering is a meal offering in a deep pan, it shall be made of fine flour with oil. You shall present to Hashem the meal offering that will be prepared from these. He shall bring it to the Kohen, who shall bring it close to the altar. So you got to go through people in this gateway system. It's like, what movie? The Matrix. The Matrix is, you're going to go on the Matrix. You're going to hear a voice. It's going to tell you, go left, go right, go straight. And you're going to obey. And you're going to go, oh my goodness. And you're going to get to the second Matrix and the third. Everything's downloaded from the brain stem. Remember, he doesn't leave his chair. We just watch the movie. That is what God has created. It's amazing. And I have all the keys. I'm the master key. I have the keys to the abyss. It's cannabis. Cannabis, keys to the abyss. He shall bring it to the Kohen, who shall bring it close to the altar. The Kohen shall lift up its memorial portion, and the memory system is activated. You're going to remember it. It's going to stick. It is a stick. It's funny like that. Its memorial portion from the meal offering, and cause it to go up in smoke on the altar. A fire offering, a satisfying aroma to Hashem. The remnant of the meal offering is for Aaron and his offspring, his son, his child, his kid, his seed. Any way you spell it, it's still going to be a child of God. You have to be a CD. You're going to have to follow me. Like Jesus said, I'm the thread, I'm the way, I'm the truth. Yes, no more lying. Pinocchio, we're made of fairy dust, and God can tell if you're lying. God knows if you're telling the truth. In fact, you know if you're telling the truth. Okay, so stop lying. That's the first step. Okay, if there's 10 steps, stop lying. Thank you, Hashem, for giving me the courage to stop lying. And just do it daily. Just, oh, and then you'll think, you're like, oh, maybe I shouldn't say that. Because that's not the truth. The truth is the truth. So this is the fiery offering to Hashem. Any meal offering that you offer to Hashem shall be prepared, leavened, for you shall not cause it to go up in smoke. Any meal offering that you offer to Hashem shall not be prepared leavened. Oh, right. For you shall not cause to go up in smoke from any leavening or fruit honey as a fire offering to Hashem. You shall offer them as first fruits. We have the first fruits of Zion, the aroma of food. You shall offer them as first fruit offering to Hashem. We have now surpassed everybody that is Jewish that speaks of the first fruits of Zion, because we know it has to go up in smoke like Cheech and Chong. Everything's up in smoke. That's the funny thing about Cheech and Chong. You really have to smoke a bong and a bowl full of fragrant incense. And it's all for Hashem, because you're going to develop into flour, kush. Okay, then you're getting a little hash on top to round out your offering. but they may not go up on the altar for a satisfying aroma. So now it has to go up and smoke. It may not go. Will it go? Is it going to go? Not go? Is it going to stay fair? Is it going to be foul? Is it going to be the air? Is it going to be a bad aroma? Are you going to smell good or bad? So, you may not discontinue the salt of your God's covenant. You may not discontinue the salt of your God's covenant from upon your meal offering. On your every offering shall you offer salt? Hash. Just sprinkle a little hash. Now, when you bring a meal offering of the first grain, the seven heads of grain in Genesis 41, when you bring the first offering of the grain, so when Jesus goes out to the grain fields to eat, and he says, have you never read what David did with the consecrated bread to make you concentrate a little bit more without getting distracted by food? The grain to Hashem from ripe ears, parched over fire, ground from plump kernels, shall you offer the meal offering of your first grain. You shall put oil on it and place frankincense on it, a meal offering. The Kohen, the seed and descendants of Aaron, that's us. We are starting the Kohen. You want to be part of the Kohen, the Doff family, the Jew Doff family, so we can doff God and take the day off and take our shoes off and Hakuna Matata, no more worries. The Kohen shall cause. The Kohen shall cause its memory, its memorial portion, to go up in smoke from its flour and its oil, as well as its frankincense, a fire offering to Hashem, of course. We do all of this for Hashem.
Are you ready?
Are you ready? Are you ready?
Yeah.
Yeah. A load of doves. It's fergalicious. It's delicious. If you didn't bring some cannabis, take your broke ass home. C-A-N-U-O-U, cannabis. How can you believe in us? The tree of life. The cannabis. So this is what I do every day. I hang out in the dance club and I read his stories and he talks and, you know, doing the rings. A fire offering. Who knew? Gotta go. Baruch Hashem for high school. Ross Hale. No records I sell.